Now that we have learned about the fundamental logic operators, not, and or, let's take a look at some other logical operations that are often used in discrete math. This table shows four new logical notations that we will cover in this lesson: implication, biconditional, the universal quantifier, and the existential quantifier. Pay close attention to the phrases associated with each, as well as the symbols that are used. This is a notation for an implication statement, which is read, if P, then Q. The proposition P is a hypothesis or premise, and Q is a conclusion or a consequence. The entire implication can be true or false, as well as each proposition separately. Let's take a look at a simple example. This implication consists of two propositions, either of which could be true or false. The proposition P, dark clouds are in the sky, is a hypothesis or a premise. And Q, it will rain, is a conclusion or a consequence. This statement is read, if dark clouds are in the sky, then it will rain. When P is true, Q will always be true, based on the rules of implication. What about if P is false, meaning there are no dark clouds in the sky? Can Q also be false? Yes. This is called an inverse statement, which is always true for an implication statement. Again, according to the rules. It is read, if not P, then not Q. Now, there are two more true or false combinations we have not yet considered. Pause the video for a moment and think about the result for those two remaining combinations. Okay, let's see how you did. Here's what a completed implication table looks like. In the second row, P is true, but Q is false. This contradicts the rules of implication in that when P is true, Q is always true. Therefore, this is a false statement altogether. It is not possible, according to this implication, that there are dark clouds and it is not raining. Make sense? Now, the third row might be puzzling, especially why it is considered true. It says that even though P is false, Q is still true. Can it really rain when there are no dark clouds in the sky? According to this implication, yes. You've seen rain happen when the sun is shining bright. It doesn't happen very often, but occasionally it does. Regardless of the implication statement, these four combinations always result in this table. Study it carefully. This is a notation for a biconditional statement, which is read, Q, if and only if P. Unlike an implication, which is considered a one-way situation, a biconditional is a two-way statement. If and only if is a phrase that is used, as you can see in the example here. For this situation, just as an implication, when P is true, Q is also true. The inverse situation is also true. No dark clouds, no rain. Both opposite situations, however, result in a false statement. As you did with the implication table, think about the example we just examined and complete the entire table shown for a biconditional using the combination shown at the bottom left. Note again that a biconditional statement is true only when P and Q have the same value, either both true or both false. Study this table carefully. Now, let's move on to universal quantification. The universal quantification symbol is the inverted A, followed by X, which represents one member of a set called the universe of discourse. We'll explain more about that in a moment. Universal quantification also uses something that is similar to a proposition, called a predicate. Here we have a predicate called P, with the variable x as its parameter. The difference between a proposition and a predicate is that a proposition only uses concrete values, where a predicate uses a variable, which can change values. A predicate is true or false based on the value being considered. This statement is read, For all values of x, p of x is true. It is like an implication, but instead of just one value being used, it considers an entire set of possible values, found in the set called the universe of discourse. The universe of discourse is a universal set for the given situation, which just means all the values that are being considered for this situation. It could be the set of all real numbers, or all the letters in the English alphabet, or all the members of a teacher's classroom. Here is a set of all the letters in the English alphabet, which we will use in an example as the universe of discourse. Here is a simple example of a universal quantification. Study it carefully, see how the statement is read, and what it means. As you can see, the sentence is a classic version of an English sentence that contains all of the letters of the alphabet. The universal quantification statement supports this idea. Here is another situation with a formal and an informal translation. Here is still another example to consider. Next, we will look at the existential quantification, represented by the reversed letter E, which translates, there exists, or there is at least one. Previously, in universal quantification, we were working with all the members of the universe of discourse, or all of the values of the set being considered. By contrast, existential quantification only cares that at least one of the values makes the situation true. This existential quantification of a predicate, P of X, can be translated as, there exists an X in the universe of discourse such that P of X is true. Pause the video, study this example for a moment, and work out the translation. What does it say in plain English? Okay, let's see how you did. You could also say it even in simpler terms, like, at least one student at this university is a genius. Let's take another example. Let's say that the universe of discourse is all real numbers. What does this statement mean? Pause the video for a moment and try to translate this statement. Did you get it? In this lesson, we reviewed the implication and the biconditional operations, which combine propositional statements. We examined how truth tables help us to visualize the results of these combinations. We also reviewed universal and existential quantifications, studying a few examples of each. These concepts are an important part of discrete math, and it is important that you have a good grasp on these fundamental ideas.